This is the house where Shakespeare was born in April 1564, just upstairs in one of the bedrooms.
They seem to be in a big, nice house. They seem to be doing well. What did his father do?
Shakespeare's father was actually a glove maker, and he did not only live in this house, he also worked in here.
He worked here?
Yes, so it's not just a family home, it's also his workplace. His father was a craftsman, and William Shakespeare probably helped his father in the glove workshop, so he would have learned the trade of a glove maker himself. And he also managed to get quite a lot of references into his plays about gloves and leather making.
Romeo and Juliet.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, that I were a glove upon that hand.
We're pretty sure Shakespeare came to school here at King Edward's, just around the corner from the family home. William was able to attend this school for free because his father was a town councillor.
This magnificent building.
Oh, wow.
What do you think of that?
Oh, my goodness.
What type of education would he have received here?
They would have taught you how to write here, how to read. But as you got later up into the school, then the teaching was all about Latin and Greek, translating Latin and Greek into English, and writing speeches, writing stories.
Would you say that the education he received here shows in his plays, in his poetry?
Absolutely, undoubtedly. The plays are full of all those classical references and all those great stories from Latin and Greek classical literature.
Most successful playwrights of the time went to university, but Shakespeare didn't. He left King Edward's at 15, around the same time his father began to have financial difficulties.
Did it harm Shakespeare's career as a playwright that he didn't go to university?
Well, we think perhaps the opposite. At university, you were taught how to write plays. So his style, when he came into writing plays, was completely new. The text had that lovely lyrical style. It's beautiful poetry. And all the stories that he'd learnt here at the school were put into his plays. He certainly broke through this whole formal way of making plays, and suddenly a new way of looking at theatre is opened up for everybody to come and see.